Yeehaw! Oh, baby. Here we go. That's it. Oh, my gosh.
What's good, Jake?
Hey, man, you snuck up on me.
I'm sorry about
I'm
that.
I'm glad you're here.
Yeah.
Is it that time already?
It is.
Am I helping with skating today or footwear design?
No, thanks for the help on the skating.
Okay.
And teaching me all the cool tricks and stuff that you know. But I'm actually here to learn something else. Do you remember the whole tie-dye craze back in the 60s?
You know, that was a half century ago, but yes, I do remember that. Peace.
As fashion has it, what's old is always new again, right? It's pretty cyclical.
I live it.
So all the kids seem to be raving about this whole new tie-dye trend.
So that's stylish now.
That's stylish now.
So what can I do?
I'm trying to understand if there's a scientific way that I can create my own tie-dyed shoe.
A tie-dyed shoe?
Right. The process of kind of creating tie-dye is that you take a material and you have to kind of tie it and then dye it and then put it in the washing machine or whatever. But obviously with a shoe being attached to rubber, you can't really do that.
You can't really do that.
I figured you might know a way that I can kind of achieve this tie-dyed look on a shoe.
I have it.
Okay.
Believe it or not, there's an old chemical technique that I'm 150 years old called chromatography. Chrome meaning colors, graphy meaning mapping.
All right.
Color mapping. So I'm going to get some chromatography materials out from underneath the wizard desk. It's amazing what we keep under here, isn't it?
It is.
This desk almost reads your mind on your way here.
I think you might have pulled a car out of this
desk.
Yeah,
I know. So I've got some markers, and those are alcohol-based markers. And some
droppers.
If you want to be a scientist, you know, you'd say a pipette.
A pipette.
And a methyl alcohol. I got that at the paint store. And just for testing purposes, I've got some spare cloth and I put it in an embroidery hoop.
Okay.
This is going to be our test shoe.
All right. Did
you bring some shoes, by the way?
I did.
Let me see what you brought. Ooh.
So these are a pair of Vans. A lot of kids are getting these canvas all white shoes and they're kind of customizing themselves.
But you want the tie-dye effect.
But I want mine to be tie-dye.
Let's try two or three pins here and see which works better. I'm gonna make a dot right here and let some of that ink soak into the cloth. So now that the magic marker is drying out, we're gonna add some more solvent.
Okay.
I'm gonna put a drop of alcohol right on that red and green.
Okay, that kind of looks
kind of
cool.
Isn't that kind of cool? It's starting to spread, right?
To it, yep.
And if you look very carefully, you see the yellow?
Yep.
If there is a mixture of colors, it will separate them, leaving the larger molecules closer to the center and the smaller molecules will go out.
Got it.
You never know what combination of inks they put into a marker. Obviously there's some yellow dye in there. That's why I would practice on a piece of cloth many times before I did it to the shoe.
Right.
I want to get my technique down.
Ooh. All right.
Now look what's happening to that brown. Look at that. Do you see it?
The greens are separated.
Where did that green
come from?
Oh,
that's interesting.
That is interesting. That's a different size molecule.
And then on the green one, I'm starting to see the blue separate.
Well, look, there's some blue over here.
So the blue and the yellow that makes the green is actually separating.
Yeah.
I think the cool thing is artist expression is up to the individual. So I mean, from there, it's just a matter of applying your own individuality, whatever design and stuff you have in mind, and then treating it with, this is just alcohol, right?
Alcohol.
Awesome.
And that'll eventually dry and it's in there.
Right on.
You do have to remember, though, this is flammable, so don't do something stupid and then blame it on me.
Let me go ahead and see what I can do to this shoe here. I want to see if I can use all of the colors that we have and see how they interact together once I add the alcohol.
Can you smell the alcohol coming off those markers as you put it on?
I really can.
That's why we use alcohol as the solvent to move it around. It's the same liquid that the original dye is suspended in.
All right. I've got the lines kind of spaced out so that it gives them some white space in between.
Is there space for the spread?
For the spread, yep. Let's see what happens.
Let it cook. That looks pretty good now.
Yeah, I think it bled really well.
You did all right.
Pretty interesting, huh? I'm gonna add a couple
of phase two now.
Drops to it and see if I can elaborate on this concept of ours. I wanna seem a little more sparse than the other areas.
Oh, look at that. Oh, a raindrop effect or the splotch? Well, that's just continuing the process, isn't it? It's pushing the molecules out.
So, I created the design. It doesn't look like much, but it's just, you know, a series of lines that bled together and I kind of like it.
Yeah, that's you, man.
Here's what we came up with. We want to see what you can do.
Yeah, so post it and tag us, whatever that means.
Well, there's a app called Instagram.
Instagram.
Yeah, it's just minor.
Very fast grand.
But there's a couple of people on it. Thank you for having me, Jake.
You're welcome.
I had such an awesome time here, and I tend to always leave here learning something new. So
I
appreciate it.
And I was inspired.
Right on, my man.
Right on.
Good to see you. Talk to you soon.
Skate on, isn't that what it is?
Yes, sir.
You skate on. And hey, when you come back next time, bring me some of those Instagrams. Sneaker science. Is that a cereal? Like graham cracker Instagrams?